Hello, art lovers.
This is art.
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Wile E. Coyote, genius.
And this is smart.
And this is
art.
This is Mr. Captains from the South Lawrence East School. This is the second part of our card drawing workshop lesson, and we'll be working on today color, of coloring the cards that we were drawing in the last lesson. I'm just drawing something really quick here just to show you. There's a word that we were discussing in last week's lesson, and that word is this here, A. E R O D Y N A M I C X S. Aerodynamics. And what aerodynamics is, we were talking about that, and I said to you, what do you think that aerodynamics is? And I was hoping that some of you perhaps looked it up, and it is to deal with the air relating to an object. The object is the automobile. Aerodynamics works around the car because it's the relationship of the object in motion, which is the car, and the air that surrounds it in motion. And what happens is, if a car is boxy and square and it's going down the road at about, say, 50, 60, 70 miles an hour, do you think that the wind will fight that car? Probably the answer would be yes. Actually, if the car is a better shape to go with the wind, then the air works with the car. It doesn't work against it. So you have the word called aerodynamics, and it deals with the object in motion, such as, like, we'll be doing this with this car here. So if we have a car that's built here, what happens is that the wind, when you're driving, will actually travel around like this and around the car. The wind travels like this in a stream in the car that's moving, but also the wind goes this way, travels here, and goes up. And what happens is that the more curves of the automobile, the less resistance that the air will give, so the car is able to save gas and actually able to move faster. So you can see that this is aerodynamics. Well, Mr. Cap, as one student said, what does that have to do with drawing a car? And that, I would say, is everything. Because here you can see this car, all right, and it's very much shaped with aerodynamics and shaped with a lot of curves. You can see that the curve is here, you can see here. You can see that the mirror has a curve, the windshield is curved. You might even notice that today's automobiles, can you see the windshield wipers? Most of the automobiles today don't have the windshield wipers showing. They're hidden, because as the air goes up, it actually can actually hit the windshield wipers, and it can actually slow the car. How many of you ever seen one of those Mack trucks that are driving around like this? Here's the coach, and here it is here, and here's the window, and here's the guy, and here's the car, the coach of the cab, okay, and here is the exhaust, and here's the guy driving this thing, okay, and here is the back, and carrying the cargo. How many of you have ever noticed one of these? on the top of the coach. That again is dealing with aerodynamics. Once again, the wind goes like this and travels right over. Now, if that wasn't there, then this is what would happen. Straight into the other half of this truck, causing it resistance. And when it causes resistance, it uses up gas because the engine has to work faster, the engine has to work harder. One boy asked me, he said, well, what does this have to do with drawing our cars? A lot, I told him, because he drew this. He actually drew this, and here is the hood, the top of the car, here is the bottom. But can you see how big this is? Look at how small this is. And again, it looks like this, but a lot of this would be really, really too big for the car. It would actually fight the car. Actually fight the air. Boys and girls, whenever you're drawing a car, here's what you have to do. Keep it streamlined. Now, Mr. Cap, what does streamline mean? Does it mean a river, but it means streamlined. Stream could also mean an airstream. So the actual stream of the air is traveling as the car is moving. So keep the car streamlined. In other words, keep it close to the ground. Keep it less resistance as possible in designing it. Keep it without any big bulks to it or big square box to it or anything, but keep it a nice flowing shape with a lot of curves. Keep it sleek. Keep it streamlined. So what happens is, whatever you make, you're making a windshield like this. Keep the car low to the ground. Keep it low to the ground, like this. Again, look at this. Same car as drawn before. But then again, you can see that the air will travel like that. Travel right along the side. I want you to also, this week, your assignment is walk around and look at automobiles. Look at them in the parking lots. Watch them on the highway. Watch how they perform. But also notice door handles. Are door handles a thing of the past? Years ago, a door handle looked like this. Here was a piece of metal. Here's this little keyhole right here. This was the door. And the metal would actually stick out. So if we were looking at the side of the car, we would see this. That was the door handle. This is the side of the car. Like this would be the hood. That's the side. Have you noticed that they got rid of that? How many people have cars at home, their families have cars that you can just put your hand in the handle is inside the door, almost like a scooped out hole where you can actually do that. How many people notice the windshields? Like I told you before, the windshield wipers are missing. How many notice how low they are to the ground cars today? How many notice all the different curves, how sleek the windshield is, how sleek the mirror is? Even that little mirror. Years ago, mirrors used to be like this on cars. And you see the 1950 Chevys, and you see all these, they would be like this. Do you notice today that they're almost like this? And again, what does it deal with? So keep your car designed with the concept of aerodynamics. Your car will work and function right and correctly, saving gas, less engine wear if the car is shaped to deal with the air in motion. I remember we were discussing in the classroom about keeping your drawings at a curve, keeping the drawings very much like very sleek, running lines like in the form of aerodynamics, but the other word is also called streamlined. Here you can see the car is low to the ground right here, so that if the air is traveling, the airstream would go like this, okay? The aerodynamics of this car is built to handle the air that it's going against on the highway. So if you're looking, the air is traveling like this, and the air is traveling down and up and right over the side. Now this car is designed to deal with aerodynamics and is really airstreamed in design. If you can notice this here, you can see that this is the mirror. Notice the mirror. It has this curve right here, again, for the air to come around like this. So you can notice when you're drawing, things are rounded off. Cars are rounded off here to receive the air, that the air is traveling, the air against it. We don't want the car to fight against the air, but we want the car to go with the air. So when you're drawing, round off the corners of your automobile. Round off, if you can see. Notice there's a grill. There's always a grill here because the air goes right through. It cools the engine, but it also goes through so it does not fight the air. You can notice the lights are hidden here, that they go up and down automatically. Again, the air will just travel here again. So the idea is to create a drawing of a car that is aerodynamically shaped. Cars of the 1990s now have the windshield wipers are usually hidden from view. It's a nice sleek design, but also it reduces the use of the air fighting against the automobile traveling on the road, so that the air goes like this and goes right up. So sometimes you see a lot of the new cars, most of the new cars will have these windshield wipers that are hidden. Unlike this one right here, you can see the windshield wipers are here, the air will still hit this and go up. But you can see that they're both designed aerodynamically to work with the wind, with the air on the highway. You can also notice something that's very important as well. And if you step over here, I'll show you. Working with the design, you can notice there is no door handle, but the door handle is part of the car. So if you can see this right here, it doesn't stick out. So when the air is traveling, once again, the air is traveling and working with the car, not against the car. If you look over here at the older design, you can see here's the door handle here, but the wind will hit this. But again, it will still work with it, but probably not as good as this because there is practically no visible handle that is seen right here. There is another door handle, and the door handle is inside again, and there is nothing sticking out to fight the air that's traveling. Keep your car streamlined, keep it smooth, keep it sleek. Look at the roundness. This is what the 1990s and into the year 2000, cars will become more and more like those of the 1930s, where they were all very, very round. A lot of the cars in the 1970s were box type. Can you take a look sometime, go to a parking lot? Just take a look and see if you can pick out cars that were made probably around 1970 to the probably middle 1980s. If you notice them, you'll see that they're more boxier type because this concept of aerodynamics started to really come back in probably in the 1990s, will continue well into the year 2000. We left off last week, boys and girls, in working with the basic drawing. As you can see here, we have the basic drawing of the 1979 Camaro. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to work with color. Oh, Mr. Cap, that's easy. All I have to do is just color it in. Wrong. Actually, we're going to try to create the illusion again, the feeling of shade for the car. Because as the car goes to the ground, it gets more curved as it reaches into, gets to the bottom of the ground. It bends inwards. I'm going to do it again, Dave. So what happens, boys and girls? Okay. Yeah, go ahead. Okay. Last week we were working with color, and that's what we will be doing today. We will be working with color gradation, or the creating of shade of our basic drawing of the Camaro. As I started last week, I started with the color red, and I'll proceed with the color red. Again, you can use light blue, light green. Stay away from brown or black or yellow, because we really can't get feelings of shade by putting overlays. That means putting the color over two or three times. Take your magic marker right now, and what happens is this, boys and girls. You don't want to use your magic marker like this, because you'll get some unevenness in color. If you're working in a body shop, you have to pretend you have a spray gun. And you're actually going like this. The body shop man that actually spray paints the car takes the gun, the spray gun, and goes one, then stops, two, three, so he can get even strokes. Now, magic markers, you're never going to get 100% even strokes, but you'll still get a nicer balance of color if you go all the way across. One, two, three, then finish over here. Now you can do one section at a time, but go from wheel well. What's a wheel well, by the way? If you were listening last week, it has something to do with the wheel. So we call it a wheel well, and we call the car the carriage. So what we do here is we're just actually putting in the main color. But Mr. Cap, do I put like two or three coats on now? Slow down, take your time. Just do this all the way across. Follow that magic marker all the way across. Even if you get some different dark and lights in some places, that's okay. Try to get a brand new marker too. Those always help. So now what Mr. Cap is actually doing is finishing the carriage. Right here. Okay. Now it's going right up here, finishing the body. One, two, three, four, five. There it is. That's the body. Now, girls and boys, if you're looking at this here, you can see this strip right here that's in the middle. That strip is sometimes a piece of chrome strip. That's also to prevent other cars. Boys and girls, when you look at this, you'll see a line in the middle. Sometimes you'll see on these cars, that's a piece of chrome. If you look over here, you'll see a piece of chrome right here. Notice here that you see the piece of chrome. That's to stop other cars from, when they open their doors, that they would hit this and dent the car. Here you can see that this is another nice car. It's a Cura. And if you can look at this here, you can see how aerodynamically proportioned it is to deal with the air. So if the air was here and this car was traveling down the road, it would almost be fast moving down the road. And if you can see, the wind would be going like this. Right down and right around. So you can see how this car is created. Do you notice this? Do you notice this? Do you notice how aerodynamic proportioned they are? Do you notice how the lights curve right here? There isn't any part of the car that actually sticks out. It almost looks like a turtle. It's all round, all shaped nice and round. But something else that's very important also is creating the color. So if you look at this car again, do you see how dark the color is here? Do you see how light the color is up here? Once again, we're dealing with the sunlight. So what happens is that the sunlight is coming down directly on the car. Could be coming from the sides as well. But if you look right here, the car starts to turn inwards right here. And as it gets closer to the ground, it gets darker. So what are we going to do? We're not going to put black. Some boys and girls will say, hey, I know what to do, I'll put black. And if you have brown up here and you have black, you don't have shade, but you have a two-tone car. You don't want that. You want to create the same color with a feeling of shade with the same magic marker. Let's try it. You've already done one coat on the carriage. Now, to create, again, the feeling of shade, what I'd like you to do is go over a second time only up to the center chrome strip. Right here. All the way across. One, two, three, four. Now, if you look closely, you can see that the bottom half of the car, from the chrome strip down, the color appears richer, like a darker red as well, but it's the same magic marker. Again, one, you can do it again, two, three. You keep going until they look like two colors of red, here and here. Now, to create again, the car starts turning more and more down towards the ground. The bottom half, there's, you've already done one coat, you've already done two coats. So that's one coat for the body. Second coat, half the car. Third coat, the bottom half. Right here, the lowest part. Look at this, boys and girls. This is the part that really curves in towards the ground. Look at this. So what happens is you just keep on going with the color over and over until it really bleeds. Again, bleeds. The paper gets saturated with the marker. And the more you do, the more the color will blend. So you can see this right here starting to really show up. Here's a red light. Okay, you can put that red light there. Now, here we have it. Here we also have the top. Don't forget the mirror. Now, the top would be run a second coat on the top. One line. Second look here on the top part of the body across. Now you're going to have darker, lighter, darker, real dark. Now the body is finished. You can see that. We're on our way to a good design. With the tires, it's very important to realize that the tires rest within the wheel well. Okay? They don't stick out, except for some of the hot rods and some of the cars of today. They have big souped up car tires. But for a regular car, the body overlaps the tire. So the tires are like inside the body. We need to create the illusion of shade. So what you're doing is, first of all, you're coloring in the wheel well around the tire, the same as the black tire. And then you stop right at this point here, so you can see that here is one wheel well here. Say wheel well, five times real fast. Okay, and then you have what's called the mag wheels here. So you can do anything. Have some fun. Create dots. Create circles. Anything that you really want to do here, create your own mags. But we haven't really created some shade. So here's what we do. The top half of the tire is in the shade. So taking your magic marker, again, it's going like this with just some lines. Just start, even if you can't see them showing up yet, like this. Do a couple and then stop. Halfway down on the tire. Same with the other one. Even if it's a little gray. There. So then if you look at that again, you will see that it creates the illusion of the feeling of shade. Just like we did last week, we put the black underneath the car with the magic marker, same as the tire, run it the length of the coach right here. Don't make it past the coach, because remember, it's the only thing that's in the shade is that car. Okay, like that. We have that. Now, I'm gonna stop, Dave, okay? Now, no, wait, don't, okay. Using a, it's okay, now, all right. Okay. Now, what we want to do is we want to create the feeling that the automobile is resting on the ground. We've already created the shade here. Try drawing the box like I did last week around it, the box, and using a gray magic marker, which is very difficult to find unless you go to a professional art store, I would say just use a pencil. And in that box, just start creating the shading of the ground that's around the automobile itself. So what you're doing is you're actually doing this. Long strokes, try to stay in the lines here, all the way around. So if you do that, boys and girls, you can go any way you want. However, use a good pencil and make sure it's sharp. And look what happens. You're actually creating a feeling that the car is sitting on the ground, on the road, where it's supposed to be. If you leave it without the box in the shade, then the car is floating in the air. Do you notice on this one here that you have this color here? And also, look, the black line. Do you see the black line? That's the shadow of the car that's right here. You can see that. Now, one thing I would suggest is when you're drawing glass, okay, be very careful that you actually, this is a drawing again, a rendering it's called, of a car. It's not a photograph. If you want a photograph, you might as well just take a picture of it. So this is your drawing and your design. But remember, this is white and the paper is white. How can we get the feeling that this space here is glass? And what we would do is we would actually use a pencil, again, very, very lightly, tinted windows, glass. So what we would do is using this, okay, we would actually just color in the glass very lightly with pencil, like this. And then what you would also do is second coat on the headrest and the steering wheel. And there you have the inside. Special trick, special art tip. You want to create the illusion of a shine on the glass. Take your eraser and just go like this. Hit a nice little white spot here and there. Hit another little spot like here, right here. Hit one right there. That'll almost give the illusion, again, of something like the glass is shining. Don't forget, you can put your name on the car. Who makes the car? Is it your car? You can put a name here. You can put a spoiler. Put a radio antenna, and I should say TV, because a lot of cars have TVs. And the big limousines do. But also you could put the cellular phone one and the line here, for the radio. And that's actually what we have here for the car. So if you look closely, you can see how aerodynamically shaped this is to deal with the wind. You can also notice the color. You can also notice the shade. You can also notice the ground. So what I want you to do this week is go onto the road, alongside the road, look at the different cars. Look at the way they're shaped to deal with the air. Of course, they're not going to be doing anything if they're just sitting there. But when you're driving with your family in a car, notice them on the highway. Notice how low they are to the ground. Can you tell which ones are the newer ones, which ones are the older ones? We get better and better every year with realizing that the more curved, the more shaped our cars are closer to the ground, the easier it is for the engine to work and the savings of gas, and the car moves a lot more freely. So look on the road. Tell me which ones are the new ones. Tell me which ones are the old ones. Boys and girls, what I want you to do also is, boy, Mr. Cap, I wish I had some books on cars. Go to the library. Also, I would say, look in the magazines, but newspapers are great. If you look on the automobile section, you'll see Isuzu, you'll see Ford, you'll see Buick, you'll see all sorts of cars. You'll see a pen and ink drawing of these cars. Clip them out, actually cut them out, and make a little file. Keep them in an envelope. Use them for references. Take a tire, like tires from this car, take the body from that car. Try all different things and have some fun. But also, you can go to a car dealership. Car dealers, okay? And you know that they're on the highway a lot of places. Have mom and dad or somebody that's living at home go in and get a bunch of brochures. These are brochures. Brochures are offered for free. People are interested in buying a car. So I hope this was helpful to you. Remember, it's your car. Draw it the way you want to. Design it. Keep aerodynamics in mind. And most of all, have fun. Create a car. Create a car of the future. Create a car of the present. Create a car of the past. It's all up to you. But the most important part about it is to have fun doing it. So I'll see you again next week. We have another new art project coming up, and join me again next week.